paying tribute to the leader of the Democratic Alliance, Helen Zille, the leadership of the Democratic Alliance, and the general membership of the Democratic Alliance. Viva Democratic Alliance, viva!
Viva!
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 I have been part of electioneering processes before, and I know that when people are still warm from an electoral process, there is something that makes them not as open as usual. So I thought we should do it much louder so that we get a sense of ease within our souls. I am pleased to address this Federal Congress on behalf of my principal, the President of the Africa Liberal Network, Honorable Olivier Kamitatu, who is also leader of your sister party, the Alliance for the Renewal of Congo, who would have loved to be here and shared with you his statement and probably also the experiences they are having at the Democratic Republic of Congo. He is unable to come. And I want to believe that the fact that there is a situation and a special problem in the Democratic Republic of Congo, he has been immobilized. But when we are together in the Ivory Coast, he mentioned to me many times how much he will be here. He was not about to be here, he was going to be here. And it really is a pain for me that he could not come. But he sends his warmest and kindest regards to all of you members of the Democratic Alliance. I am also here in my own capacity and right as the Vice President of the Africa Liberal Network, responsible for Southern Africa, as well as leader of a sister party, the Botswana Movement for Democracy. And I'm here alongside ALN delegates from Zambia, from Malawi, from Tanzania, from Kenya, from Uganda, from South Sudan, Sudan, Ethiopia, and the Seychelles. All coming here to wish you a successful and productive Federal Congress. I must hasten to say that all of us are impressed with the work that you are doing, right from the staff that are very warm when they receive guests, very organized enterprise in this Congress, everything to detail, made to be produced to show and demonstrate the wealth and the picture and the dignity of what the DA is all about, your leadership. The whole program in terms of the people who were receiving awards yesterday, because of the hard work that they put not only for the DA, but put it for South Africa in order to advance a good cause that the DA is representing. We thought we were coming in, Madam Leader, as just well wishers. We are so happy to say we came in to realize that more than just being well wishers, we were learners. We have learned a lot. We are a network that is growing, as my colleague just said. But our charge is to spread liberal values across the African continent, to facilitate the development and growth of liberal parties, liberal organizations and liberal individuals in all African countries, to encourage solidarity among members with the aim of assisting them to achieve power through democratic means, to establish an alliance of like-minded liberals in Africa for the sharing of information, sharing of experiences, sharing of skills, and sharing of ideas. Congress and delegates, what a pleasure it is to be in Johannesburg. for those of us who are visiting. What makes it even a greater pleasure is the fact that this weekend, all roads were leading to Johannesburg. And for those of us who have read and enjoyed Alan Painter, are aware of the fact that when roads lead to Johannesburg, then a country, a beloved country, must be crying. We may not be sure because we are visitors what the cry could be about. And we are only wondering, could it be because of the rampant bad business within the economy? Could it be because of the absence of job opportunities of young people, young men and women, while others firmly lose their jobs? Could it be the wanting levels and measures of people's public services and their delivery? Could it be patronage and cyber-fancy promoted by those in power? Could it be the institutionalization of mediocrity in public institutions? Could it be the centralization of power to serve the end of those to whom it was given with trust? Could it be the clinical regulation of the economy for the benefit of a small clique, hence the rise of tenderpreneurship? Could it be the compelling suspicions that homestead renovations for significant others of the society are allegedly funded by an unsuspecting public? Could it be because of the flaunting of the Constitution, its letter and its spirit, by those who are supposed to protect it the most and the best? We are not sure. What we know in terms of our liberal values is that both should be at the center. Rona Botswana ra re thong both. Re raya gore ha o netse dilo o tshwanetse gore o di tlhokomela la batho. O tlhabiwa ke dithong. Ka fa o tsenwe ke moanyana o sa tshwanang. Sadly, this is a pattern other African countries and those particularly in the African Liberal Network will recognize too well just what I said. We have all seen politicians put themselves above the interest of the people they are elected to serve. Even my own country, Botswana, once considered a model of a shining star of democracy and development. On the African continent is only a shadow of its old self. We have seen the personalization and the privatization of the state, and the abuse of positional privileges as well as an ending tale of livid corruption and a widespread collapse of governance. It is for this reason that we shall not sleep, neither shall we slumber, in making sure that we restore the dignity of our nation. It is on this note that I should now come back to this Congress and not dwell at home, because otherwise my cup will overflow. I should hasten to come back and focus my attention on a recent visit that we had from one of your children, one of your sons, Jonathan Brooks, your chief executive officer, who came to Botswana with Lord Chris Brenner, former chief executive officer of the Lib Dems in the United Kingdom, to enlighten us about campaigns management, and campaigns messaging. Your Jonathan Moles and their Chris Brenner took us through teachings that saw us win a very critical by-election. Listen, you would like to know why this by-election was critical. This by-election was critical because, as you would have discovered, the party that I have the honor to lead is only 2 years old. And it was born after the general election. This was the first election it was involved in ever since its foundation. And it was a by-election. And what we did was just to simply win the by-election because of that. And our partners, the Botswana National Front, and the Botswana People's Party, and indeed the Botswana Movement for Democracy, say we should say to Jonathan Holmes, say to your leadership, Madam Helen Zille, and say to all of you, members of the Democratic Alliance, thank you very much for Jonathan Holmes and the leadership. We are indeed glad as the African Liberal Network Group that our roles have led us to Johannesburg. There is nowhere more appropriate for our network to gather than here in Johannesburg, where a DA victory in 2014 will mark the beginning of the end of the African him to us over the years, as well as thank him for his dedicated service, for his professionalism, for his leadership, for his management of projects of the network, his convivial personality, his studious attention to detail in his administrative and political service as coordinator. These have been key to the success of the network. And for all this, we are grateful and wish you, Nick Branson, well in your future endeavors. With these remarks, God bless the leadership of the Democratic Alliance. God bless the Democratic Alliance, and God bless South Africa.